I'm not an anti-vaxxer, but I still carried my anxiety to the vaccine center. I was very sure I wanted to get vaccinated and was thrilled when the government announced that everyone above the age of 18 was eligible to get vaccinated. So thrilled that I texted all my friends asking them to register. After days of trying religiously on the Cowin app, I failed to get a slot for myself. Enter my messiah. A friend who wasn't eligible for vaccination herself, but had major FOMO about not playing fastest finger first on the app. She asked to be entrusted with booking mine, and voila, she did it. Get me a slot she did for the very next day. While I was elated, my anxiety reminded me that I probably needed a little more than 24-hour notice to be fully prepped for my shot, and my mind was soon sipping on a cocktail of relief and fear. My hyper-anxiety stemmed from two things: months of social isolation and genuine fear of contracting the virus. While I knew taking preventive measures like double masking and social distancing would be enough to keep me safe, the apprehension of going back into the world, even if to get vaccinated, was like nothing I had ever experienced before. It was an hour and a half drive to the vaccination center. I went alone on the most paranoia-filled cab ride ever. So what did my mostly irrational fear list feature? What if I step out and bring the virus home? What if vaccines are out of stock by the time I reach the center? What if the place is crowded and nobody maintains social distancing? What if I get a reaction after getting the dose? And worst, what if I don't get a cab back home? My name was called in no time and I went in, my worry evident on my face. I asked my doctor if the medication I was on would be a problem. She smiled and told me it wouldn't. And then, finally, it was time for my shot, and it was done in less than a minute. My doctor told me that over the next few days, I may develop a fever or feel nauseous. But don't panic, she said. It's normal for your body to react to a vaccine. I was glad she told me this because I actually felt a sense of relief and calm. I was asked to wait, and those were the most calming 30 minutes I had felt in a while. All my anxiety and worries were leaving, and my heart felt light and nice. While coming back home, I asked my cab driver if he got his vaccine, and he nodded and said, "Yes, ma'am." Once back home, I did feel the side effects: fever, muscle pain, sore arm, and fatigue. All these lasted 3 days. My arm felt so heavy. But all this was gone in a week and my life was back to normal. Now, I wait for my second shot, keeping irrational thoughts and fear at bay by staying home, masking up and maintaining social distancing. I know I'm lucky and privileged to get vaccinated, and there are many who aren't. The Government of India has mandated prior online registration for getting the vaccine, and that alienates many who don't have access to smartphones or the internet. So here's a list that we can follow to help. You can book a slot for those who don't have access to technology. Encourage those who help you, like your domestic helpers, security guards, to get vaccinated. Offer to book the slot and take them there. Encourage your family and friends to extend the same help. Also, don't forget to be grateful to all that you have. Help people fight COVID-19 and support COVID relief work as much as you can.